Well, hi everyone, and welcome to Community Journal. Thank you very much for joining us. We have an interesting show for you this week, and we're going to be introducing somebody in just a moment. As you can see, we have a guest, and Eileen will be telling us about that person in just a minute. But Paul, we've had an interesting spring so far.
So far.
It is very slow in getting here.
The weather stays kind of cool.
Yesterday was the first day this month that at our location we reached 60 degrees.
Well, that was good.
Boston,
I mean, at least it's April. I mean, you should expect something.
Boston has been, 84, 85, yeah. 87. We just barely made 60 yesterday for a half an hour.
Well, so, we're close to the water. Well, Boston's close to the water, too.
Yeah, I know it.
But we have more water.
I guess we do. It's been very slow in coming. We have some daffodils, Eileen. You're going to be talking about the garden club. This is sort of a good segue. We have daffodils. The poor things, they can't even bloom.
No, I don't.
They're trying so hard.
And here I am, a member of the garden club. But all good things do happen in time, Jack.
Yes, they do.
Yes, including the garden club sale,
that's
which is going to be happening. And I have with me today Denise Traver, who is one of the two co-chairs of the plant sale for the Garden Club of Harwich this year. And her partner, Liz Dubuque, could not be with us today. But thank you, Denise, for taking time to come and talk to us about this very exciting annual fundraiser that the Garden Club has every year.
Well, thank you very much for having me, Elaine and
Oh,
Jack
you're
and
welcome.
Paul. It's welcome. Great to be able to come here and tell a little bit about the plant sale that's coming up in May.
Uh-huh, and it's going to be happening, as always, on the Saturday of the Memorial Day weekend. And this year, that date is May 27th. So please put it on your calendar, because there's lots of wonderful things, including items like this beautiful basket in front of us that will be available. And Denise put this together, and I think it looks absolutely lovely. And there are going to be many more things available.
Yes, there are. We do have plants for the shade, for sun. We have veggies. We have herbs. And we have garden gifts available.
And the bake sale, don't forget
and the bake sale. Yes, the bake sale, and also floral arrangements that will be available for buying, as well as hanging baskets. Some might be available to you at the gift shop, too, or at the table with the annuals. And people might be putting some together for you in the hanging baskets.
And there's also going to be a raffle table.
There's a raffle table. We do have items coming in from our local merchants. They give us items to raffle off, and we do thank them for their contributions.
They do this every year, and it's such a wonderful thing to do.
They do. We've had planters, we've had bushes, we've had trees come in, we've had tools of the trade. They've been very generous in what they've given for the raffle. We do appreciate their input.
And some members do make items some years?
Yes.
Yes.
Members and members' husbands also contribute to the gift table, and they'll be there for sale.
Yes, good. And we also are going to have our favorite fellow that comes and sharpens your tools for you. And his name is Charlie, and he's going to be there. And for a small donation, which he donates to the Garden Club, by the way, he will sharpen what you need: garden tools, non-serrated kitchen knives, and scissors. So that's another table that we'll be having at the sale.
Yes, it is. And there's also an informational table where people will be available to help you out with flowers you might have questions about the Garden Club itself. There'll be that informational table. I also want to mention that the hours are from 9 to 12 this year, which are a little different than usual. And it will be rain or shine that it will be available.
Yes, so, and there won't be a flea market this year.
No flea market this year.
But we are going to have lots of things for you to look at that I know a lot of the Garden Club elves have been very busy since last summer. They do. They start right away. Right after the sale, they begin again for the following year. To make sure that they have a lot of handcrafted items for the garden and for you to plant, or sometimes they have other things as well. The plant sale, as I said, is going to happen on Saturday, May 27th, as Denise mentioned, from 9 to 12. And it is a fundraiser for the many things that the Garden Club does for the town of Harwich.
Yes, they do. We have planters that line our streets and our beaches. We have gardens in our various vicinities around the community that we take care of. And we also do decorating in the town and the port during the holidays also.
And window boxes and
certain and window boxes,
places
yes.
as well. Yes.
Yes.
And at the holiday time, there's always beautiful wreaths around town.
Yes.
And the planters are usually filled with greenery. And we have our annual boutique at the holiday time as well.
Yes.
So it's a very busy club, and it certainly helps to beautify our town.
Also, just to mention, it is at Doan Park in Harwichport,
mm-hmm.
across from the Post Office Square. And this is our 85th anniversary year.
Is it really?
Yes.
Oh my goodness, I didn't realize that either.
Yes, so.
Wow.
The Garden Club's been in existence for 85 years this
wow.
year.
That's wonderful. Mm-hmm. Well, that's something to celebrate.
Yes.
So please come celebrate with us on the Saturday of Memorial Day weekend from 9 to 12 in Doan Park on May 27th, and we will be happy to see you. Thank you so much, Denise.
Yes.
Denise,
you're welcome.
Thank you so much for coming in this morning. And, you know, I think sometimes people forget, you know, Harwich, you know, area-wise is a big town. There's a lot of area to cover, and it's mm-hmm. amazing how many planters you have around town, around the holidays, how many wreaths are hanging on poles and doorways. Mm-hmm. And so it just is incredible, the work that the Garden Club does and the scholarships that you have out there. You guys do wonderful work, and as a town, we thank you very, very much. And
well, thank you.
And thank you so much for coming in this morning. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
I could follow up and say I say the same thing.
Thank you both.
Thank you very much.
And to provide all this for the town, of course, it costs money, so please come and support us at the sale.
That's great.
Yes.
And, of course, coming right around the corner is April vacation, and with April vacation, there's a lot going on here at the community center. And Paul, you sat down with Eric.
Yes, Eric had a week of events. This coming week is a week off for the children at school. And there'll be a lot going on here at the community center. So
let's take a look and see what's going to be happening during April vacation.
Welcome once again to Channel 18. Our first guest today is Eric Bibby, Director of Youth and Recreation. And Eric, it sounds like you've got a great program for this coming spring season.
Yeah, we want to help out the parents and keep their kids busy as possible and tire them out so they go to sleep.
All those are delighted things.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we have a full slate of open gyms and some special activities, too.
That sounds great.
So I'll go over the special activities first. On Tuesday, April 18th, Monday, the building's closed, so there's nothing on Monday.
What's the holiday Monday? Patriots Day.
Patriots Day, yes. Right. So Tuesday the 18th, from 5 to 7 at night, we're going to have family gym games where families can come in. We'll have organized games, pillow polo, scooter soccer, basketball, basically anything they want to do in the gym. They'll have free rein, and we'll have staff here to kind of coordinate it. Wednesday the 19th, we've got a lot going on. In the morning from 10 to 1, we have what we're calling Brown Bag Beach Lunch and Boardwalk program. So we'll take up to around 10 to 15 kids in the van. We'll go down to the beach. They bring their own lunches. We eat lunch on the beach. And then we'll go get ice cream afterwards on the way home. So that one requires pre-registration from the parents, just so we know how many we're going to have in the van. And that same night, on Wednesday night, we're doing the Mad Science Show. From 5:30 to 6:30, right at the community center here.
Well, who's the mad scientist?
Well, it's a group that comes in. Their show that they're putting on Wednesday night is going to be called Up, Up, and Away, and it's going to be creating air vortexes, producing clouds before your eyes, and make people fly, and so much more is what they put on their flyer. So it sounds interesting. That one also requires pre-registration. It's just $15 per family, so it's very affordable for the show. Thursday the 20th, we're going to have another family gym game night from 5 to 7 at night. That one does not require pre-registration. You could just show up and jump right in. There's no fee at all for that. And then Friday, we're going to do another Brown Bag Beach Lunch and Boardwalk Day from 10 to 1. So we're going to have all those special events, something at least one every day of the week. And in addition to that, we're going to have our normal open gym times, which I'll read off to you quickly. On Tuesday, we're going to have family open gym from 9 to 11. So that's some of the younger ones and their parents. And we'll have regular open gym from 1 to 5 in the afternoon. Wednesday, we'll have all-age open gym from 2:30 to 5. Thursday, we'll have family open gym from 9 to 10:30, as well as all-age open gym from 12 to 5. And Friday, we're going to have all-age open gym from 3 to 6:30. So there's plenty of time to come in. I know that's a lot of information at once, but we do have these flyers right here at the community center, so come pick one up. It's also on the website, so you can get all the information there as well.
Sounds like a very good, interesting program.
Yeah, yeah, it should keep them busy. You know, I know my kids, I try to keep them busy as much as possible so they can go to bed on time, you know, and be tired enough.
Get some sleep.
Yeah, but yeah, we want to make use, you know, the beach days should be real fun. You know, you can't go wrong going to the beach and having lunch and going out for ice cream. You know?
No, there's a...
So we're lucky to have the vans that we have to be able to drive the kids around, and we'll have plenty of staff so parents can not worry about that. We'll have plenty of staff there. Yep. So that's what we got going for the vacation week. We still have some openings as well in our spring programs. They're filling up fast. We have things that are just starting up, like indoor soccer. We have t-ball. We have pickleball for kids. We have pillow polo for kids. We have a lot of different things. So come on down as soon as you can for those, though, because they fill up real fast.
When I was growing up, I don't think you even had those names.
I know. Some of them are a little confusing. I know. They're fun, though. Pickleball is it's like tennis, kind of, with wooden paddles and a wiffle ball and a much smaller court. So it's great for youth as well as seniors.
Okay.
And then pillow polo is the other one everybody asks about. And that's kind of like hockey, but very safe. It's used padded sticks and little dodgeballs. So nobody gets hurt, and they just hit it into the goals. So they have fun with that as well. So we've got a lot going on, and at the same time, we're starting to get ready for summer, which is coming up.
And when do you have your summer program?
They all start at the end of June. But what we're doing is the summer brochure should be out within the next week or so. And we have an early registration period for the whole month of May for Harwich residents.
Oh.
So Harwich residents can come down, make sure they have a spot in the summer programs they want. So we'll have the whole month of May, and then registration will shut down for a time until our big registration day on June 23rd. We're still planning on having all our normal summer programs, our camp, all our summer ball, tennis lessons.
Now, camp is overnight, is it? Or is
we have an option for a half day camp, which is from 9 to 12, Monday to Friday, or a full-day camp, which is from 9 to 4, Monday to Friday. So it's run right out of the community center, but they play on the fields out back, they go on trips, they go to the playground, all kinds of stuff. So.
Now, the rise in temperature affects whether they play or not.
If it's super hot out, we'll keep them inside here, play games in the gym. We have movies that we play for them. We have the game room. They have talent shows in the multi-purpose room, stuff like that. So if it gets too hot, we bring them inside.
Well, that's good.
Yep.
So sounds like you got everything under cover.
So far, so good. Yep.
Well, best of luck.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
Oh, Paul, Eric always has a full docket for vacations.
He does. He enjoys it.
Yeah, he really does.
He really gets into it.
Yeah, no, that's wonderful. And the kids are lucky. We're lucky. That's
yeah,
really great.
We are.
Yeah,
excellent. He takes care of a lot of entertainment.
And it's a tough crowd sometimes.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Not an easy deal.
Kids are not easy.
No, not an easy deal. Good, very good.
Change it up and change it up.
Yeah, that's right. Thank you, Paul. Eileen, you've got some announcements there that sort of dovetail.
The Garden Club.
Segment, right, exactly.
Segment, yes. The town of Harwich also knows that it's spring, and they are going to have an Arbor Day seedling giveaway on April 28th at 8:30 to noon. The Harwich Town Hall parking lot, is going to be the place where you can get many varieties, including persimmon tree seedlings, flowering white dogwood shrub seedlings, nine bark shrub seedlings, and northeastern wildflower pollinator seed mix. This is all going to happen, as I said, on April 28th. I believe it's a Saturday from 8:30 in the morning to noontime, but I would be there right away because the things do go quickly. In the event of inclement weather, the giveaway will be located in the town hall foyer. And if you need any more information, you can contact the Harwich Conservation Department at 508-430-7538.
Great opportunity.
Yes, yeah, that, I know. That's really free
great,
trees.
Oh, boy, that's a great opportunity. Yes. Yeah, very good.
We might talk about that.
Yeah,
later.
We might.
And also, there is going to be a Plants for Pets garden event. It's going to benefit the Samson Fund for Veterinary Care, which helps owners of pets that might need some help from a veterinarian, and their owner needs some help providing that. And it's going to be held on Saturday, May 20th, rain or shine, from 9 in the morning to 1. And the new location is going to be the Harwich Community Center right here on Oak Street. So that's Saturday, May 20th, from 9 to 1.
Very good. Okay. This is a yearly event that takes place. This is an important one. This is supporting the Alzheimer's Family Support Center of Cape Cod, the Dave Burtwell Memorial, the Remembery Walk. And that's going to be taking place this year, Saturday, May 13th, right at Brooks Park here in Harwich at 11 a.m. It's going to feature live music and everyone and food, and everyone is welcome. The proceeds fund free support system services for the Alzheimer's Family Support Center of Cape Cod. For more information, you can call 508-896-5170. That's 508-896-5170. And that's the Alzheimer's Family Support Center of Cape Cod. And they have a slogan, "No one should walk alone." Mm-hmm. And how true that is, you know, really, it really is. And the Dave Burtwell Memorial, that's becoming quite well known, the Remembery Walk. And again, that's Saturday, May 13th. So mark your calendar for that one.
And I believe that's a rain or shine event, too.
I believe it is. It doesn't say it on here, but I think it probably is.
Yeah, I think so, too.
And let's see. Jamie and Dinah sat down for a Chamber of Commerce update. So we're going to take a look at that right now. So let's see what's going on at the Chamber of Commerce.
From the Harwich Chamber of Commerce, and she's going to tell us about a number of things that are going on over the next month or so in Harwich. We have lots going on, and starting right here at the middle school, there are some activities that she will be talking about.
Thank you, Dinah. And Dinah and I are going to be on remote for our the next 7 months throughout the seven villages of Harwich, and we chose the middle school today on a beautiful spring day to share with everyone what happens here at the Harwich Middle School. Right now, Carolyn Carey from the Community Center is renting the space to various artists. One of our local schools just did a production of The Lion King, and it's just a beautiful building and a great way to share the arts and culture of the various groups. So that being said, we have other things coming up this month. It's a busy month. As we prepare for town meeting on May 1st at the Community Center Gymnasium. But we also have at the community, right here on Friday is the egg hunt that Carolyn will be bringing to all of the lovely little children and big children of Harwich and surrounding areas. And that is at 3:30 here at the Harwich Middle School. So, I think the Easter Bunny even shows up, so that'll be fun for all.
Lots of eggs for everyone.
Exactly, and it's a beautiful springtime event here as well. And then something that I'm not sure if this will air in time, but there are a variety of wastewater meetings happening the next few weeks prior to town meeting for the public to be aware of all the parts of wastewater and how it is such an incredible, incredibly beneficial to us to hear all this information. Today, April 12th at 6:30 in the Griffin Room will be one of those meetings as well.
Yes, there's lots of information about the wastewater proposal, and it's really important for people to inform themselves.
It is, but it's also great as we prepare for town meeting to get as much information prior to those two nights to be informed and to be a part of it too. So we really stress that everyone does come out to town meeting May 1st at 7 p.m. in the gymnasium, and then May 2nd is the special town meeting at 8 p.m. in the gymnasium.
Mm-hmm.
And then we segue into after town meeting. Everyone will be wanting something fun to do.
Yep.
So we have the Toast of Harwich on Friday, May 5th. And once again, for anyone that joined us last year, we tried a new concept, the trolley tour. We'll be doing that once again, where you start, you park your car at the community center, pick up your tickets. If you haven't already picked them up at the chamber, you can pick them up in the community center, as well as we have some tastings inside the community center. That is one of our first hubs. And in there we have the Royal Assisted Living, Wingate at Harwich, Red's Pizza, Local Flavor, and I'm going to forget someone that's in there, and I'm so sorry. But then we also, after you've picked up all the goodies at the community center, you can then hop on the trolley and go to the first hub.
Right.
Which will be 400 East. At 400 East, we'll also have a wine tasting. And 400 East will have sampling tastings, as well as La Alouette by Christian, and the Wequasset Resort and Golf Club will join us there as well. And then the next stop hub will be Cranberry Valley at the Cranberry Valley Golf Course. And you'll have Hot Stove there, as well as Buca's Tuscan Roadhouse, and another wine tasting.
Sounds fabulous.
So, yeah, it's really a wonderful night with the various restaurants showcasing their food. What we did was added hubs this year, opposed to just going to 20 restaurants. We're partnering with various buildings and to showcase those restaurants.
How long would you say each stop is?
Each stop should be about 15 minutes. And what we're going to do is we're doing something fun this year. We're having volunteers on the trolleys. So they'll be able to tell you what's going to happen
coming
up ahead.
And
tell you about all the special promos.
Taste of coming attractions.
Exactly.
Right.
So, you know, 400 East may have clam chowder or a spinach and artichoke dip. And so the volunteer on the trolley will be getting the group all excited for what they're going to have.
That sounds like a great idea. Yep.
So then our next stop, this year the hub down in Harwichport is going to be Bonat's Bakery. Alice has generously given us the space to have a wine tasting there, as well as the Cape Sea Grill will be
nice
in there,
yeah,
and Lanho with their special tastings for the night. And then another stop down in Harwichport will be the Tenyen new sushi restaurant that we're going to have.
Yes.
He's going to have a delightful Asian punch to showcase. It's a very small, intimate sushi restaurant in Harwichport in the Village Center building. And so in order to accommodate, we're going to do a special punch there this year. And then the Mad Minnow Bar and Kitchen, which is also in that building, will be showcasing tuna cannoli and some other seafood dishes.
Tuna cannoli.
Tastings, rather. And then they also have a fun Mad Dog cart. It's a hot dog cart. So that'll also be there as well. So the trolley tasting part of the event is 5 to 7. And then we have our VIP event that is 7 to 11. That is at Mooncusser's Tavern and Inn. And that we have our silent auction, as well as tastings from Mooncusser's and wine tastings as well. And then we have a band for dancing, Leslie Boyle and Friends. So tickets can be purchased through the chamber at either our website, which is www.harwichcc.com. And there's a trolley that you just click on and follow the steps, or you can come by the chamber and purchase your tickets. We have extended hours this week, even though we creeping up on the holiday weekend, we will be open for the rest of this week until 6 p.m. and then on Saturday 9 to 4 for anyone that wants to purchase tickets as well. And then next week, of course, during school vacation, we'll have extended hours too. So that takes us through the toast. And I did mention already, of course, I wanted to mention some of our sponsors. We couldn't do these events without some great partners. This year, our presenting sponsor once again is Stiefel in East Harwich. and they have been a wonderful partner over the years, as well as our trolleys, Cape Destinations. This event wouldn't have trolleys without Cape Destinations, so we want to thank them.
It's an important part of the event, yes.
And then our other sponsors, Brenda Weeks Travel, Cranberry Liquors, mm-hmm. Outer Cape Health and Services, the Cooperative Bank of Cape Cod, and the Royal Assisted Living in Harwich Port. No, mm-hmm. excuse me, in Harwich Center. Other sponsors that we'd like to thank, of course, are our global sponsors that help us throughout the year with all of our great events for the town. Robert B. Auer, Wauquasset Resort and Golf Club, Cape Cod 5 Cent Savings Bank, Cape Cod Media Group, the Cape Cod Chronicle, again, Brenda Weeks Travel, Nauset Disposal, Robert Paul Properties, Morris O'Connor and Blute, RPM Carpets and Floor Coverings, and Cape Cod Healthcare. Mm. Those are all of our wonderful sponsors that help yeah. us throughout the year.
Thanks so much to all those sponsors.
Very, very lucky.
That's
and
great.
Fortunate.
Yes, you are. And you have something coming up even before that, right? April
we
29th,
do.
You
Thank
have
you,
a
Dina. We have
special
another
event.
Great event that we're partnering with Geek Girl, which is a technology group that brings these great boot camps to people that want to know more about all the different technology things. You know, we're so savvy or not so savvy with things like WordPress, social media, and Photoshop. And so they're going to bring this camp once again. This is their second year, and we're at the Monomoy Regional High School. So we've partnered with them. There mm-hmm. is a special ticket price. If you go on the Geek Girl website, it is, and put in the Harwich 99, you'll get the special $99 rate opposed to the $169, I think it is.
Mm.
So that will, again, be at the Monomoy Regional High School.
And is that an all-day event?
That is an all-day. I believe it's 9 to 4.
Uh-huh.
So
that could be useful for so many people.
So many people.
Yeah.
Whether beginner, intermediate, you need a refresher, just, you know,
right.
Person up here,
sounds like they really know what they're talking about, so it'd be useful for those of us who aren't so tech savvy to start with, and those who want to brush up on things as well.
Right. We can always learn something new, right?
Yep.
So you learn
especially
something
in
new
this
every day, so there's another day you can learn something.
Technology
fun.
Age.
And we shouldn't be afraid of it, right? So here's a fun way not to be afraid
we
of
shouldn't.
Technology.
That's true. That's right.
Then we have something fun that kicks off the summer after school gets out is our 5K road race on Saturday, June 24th. This is an annual event that we do, and it just, you put on your sneakers and you just go and have fun with the family. It's a great event. Starts off in the municipal parking lot by our building in the chamber.
Mm-hmm.
We've got vendors there, some stretching exercises by Coco Fit, and just a lot of fun. And then we end it with the awards and party at Ember Coal Fire Pizza and Wings. And so that'll be fun. Again, that is beginning at 9:30, and that's at the Harwich Chamber. And then we...
So can you tell us, does one have to be a runner to be involved
no,
in that?
No, you can actually walk. There
so
are
there is walking.
Families with
okay.
strollers. And just, it's a fun event. You
it's a town event,
be,
really.
It really is.
Yeah.
You don't have to be, you know, training for the Boston Marathon or, you know, any of that.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a fun event for runners.
It's great. Very
and
inclusive.
If you like to run
That's
or
great.
Walk, it's just a great, great time for all.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then just a little touch on the summer, because it's such a beautiful day, we have to touch about summer.
Yep. It's right around the corner.
It is. It's, you know, I can't believe it's going to be, you know, spring, May 1st, just around the corner. But we do have, once again, on Wednesday nights in Harwich Port, the Port Summer Nights. And we are kicking that off July 5th with our Thank a Local Hero theme. Every Wednesday night, we have paired a theme with the music. So if there's a country night, that means there's going to be country bands. If there's a rock and roll night, there's rock and roll, and so on. These are Wednesday nights again, and this year we are very fortunate to have Cape Cod 5 Cent Savings as our presenting sponsor on this. And so, again, a great partner in the community with us, great fun time for families. Wednesday nights, 6 to 9, you stroll through all the shops, you eat great food, and listen to wonderful music.
It's a wonderful multi-generational event.
It is.
Loved it when I went last year one
time. What's so fun is that a lot of these bands start getting their, you know, start young, mm-hmm. and then have been with the Stroll for many years.
Uh-huh.
You know, it was first begun about, I think, 15 or 16 years ago with the Merchants Association, and then we've helped partner with it. And then last year, as the Chamber, we planned and coordinated it along with the great businesses of Harwich Port. So, again, just a fun time.
So and people who've been going for many years have seen these groups grow.
They've seen them grow
and develop
and just have followed them. You know,
isn't
so
that
many
great?
Of them on a Wednesday night, if they're not playing with us, they're at one of the local restaurants.
Mm-hmm.
And it just, you like to see the success of our local talent from Harwich. And many of the bands are either from Harwich or from the Cape, which is great.
That's fabulous.
Very, very lucky. And that's just a quick little snapshot of upcoming events in Harwich.
Yes. Well, it's a lot, and you can always go to
the Chamber
website to look up details if
absolutely.
You don't remember absolutely everything. But thank you so much for coming out and telling
you.
Us about all the wonderful
so
things that are coming
it.
Up. And thanks so much.
See you in Harwich.
Well, Dinah and Cindy certainly brought us up to date. There's a lot going
yes,
on at the Chamber.
Sure
always
is.
A lot. She has the list that keeps going like
yeah,
this.
Yeah, wow. Very, very good. Mm-hmm. Very comprehensive interview. That was well done. And Paul, I know you have a very important flyer in front of you there because this is coming up tomorrow.
Tomorrow will be the egg hunt here in Harwich, and it's going to be at the middle school. And it's going to be at 3:30 in the afternoon. So be sure you bring your little egg package so you can put the eggs in it and get ready. So we'll hope to see you all tomorrow at 3:30 at the middle school for the egg hunt.
And if you know, past years are any indication, they have a lot of eggs hidden out there.
Yes, they
do. And I imagine it's a rain or shine event.
Yeah, and I think it's supposed to be great weather.
Yes,
so,
good. So we won't have to worry about that.
So I don't think we have to worry about that. So I think that's going to be a fun time.
Yes.
Okay. And Eileen, you've got something interesting there.
I do, yes. The Cape Sands Ballroom certified dance instructor, Karen Shackelford, has made a change in her program. She is now going to begin a new swing dance night. It's going to replace the 5 o'clock pop and Latin line dancing and the 5:45 p.m. salsa dance class that she has done in the past. This is going to happen every Thursday night in April, May, and June from 5 to 6:30 right here at the Community Center. There's an optional meet and greet, a practice session, and learn a few basics from 5 to 5:30. There'll be an East Coast swing lesson for students who know the basics from 5:30 to 6:15, and practice what you learn from 6:15 to 6:30. Very well-organized lady. Singles and couples welcome. No pre-registration is required. It's $10 per person, and it's at a drop-in for your convenience. Please bring a change of shoes to help keep the floor free of sand, and bring a water bottle. That's very important to keep hydrated, because she does keep you busy. I know from personal experience. She's wonderful. She's a wonderful instructor. The last Latin and pop line dance and last Latin classes were already held at the end of March. So this is the new program for April, May, and June, Swing Dance Night, every Thursday night, 5 to 6:30.
Yeah, not only do you learn some dance moves, but you get great exercise.
Yes,
yeah,
I'm currently taking a course with her, and it's wonderful exercise.
Yeah, no,
she keeps you moving.
Yeah. Not a bad thing.
No, it's not.
Not at all. Very good. And again, we want to remind you folks that, you know, the town of Harwich is one of the rare towns that has direct town meeting, which is, you know, this is democracy in its rare, in its best form. It's going to be taking place Monday, May 1st at 7 p.m. and special town meeting May 2nd, it says here at 8 p.m. And it's right here at the community center. And, you know, this is an opportunity to know what's going on here in town. It is an opportunity to vote on the different warrants that are going to be presented. You have a direct vote, and this is an opportunity to do that. Also, there's no excuse not to be here because childcare is provided, but you do have to RSVP to arrange for childcare. to the rec department, and you can call them at 430-7553. You do have to prearrange for childcare. So again, annual town meeting. The regular meeting is May 1st at 7 p.m., and special town meeting is May 2nd. So put that on your calendar. It's right around the corner.
Yes,
it
is.
I can't believe already again. My goodness.
Time is flying by.
Seems like it was a month ago, but I, but I know it was a year ago. And let's see. We have another one more spot here on the show today. And Dinah sat down with Sheila House for the Youth Counselor update. So let's take a look and see what that's all about. Here's Dinah and Sheila House.
Hello, I'm here with Sheila House, who is the Harwich Youth Counselor. And I was very interested to learn that Harwich has a youth counselor and what a wonderful service it must be for the town. So we've asked her to come and talk a little bit about what it is she does.
Thanks.
What kinds of services do you provide, first of all?
I provide individual and group mental health counseling to my primary audience is young people ages 11 to about 24, but I also see parents for parent coaching and, you know, support as well. And there are also grandparents who are raising their grandchildren that I see for counseling.
Okay, so parent counseling for children younger than 11. And then if the children are 11 or older, you might see them individually, or would you see them in a family context as well?
A little bit of both. Mm-hmm. I like to have the parents involved in the loop, you know, so
very
it's important.
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Can you tell me a little bit about how this service for the town started and how long it's been?
Sure. The town in the early 90s started to recognize the need for somebody that could be available to kids after school and on vacations and in the summer, and just somebody that was available when the school guidance counselors and other people couldn't be available.
Right.
So they created a position. One of the people that was responsible for that is the late Bob Murray, who used to be involved with Hetch. And Bob was a selectman in Arlington, and he copied a model in Arlington. They sort of modified it.
Yes.
And created a job description, took it to town meeting, and it was very widely supported. So I began working in September of 2000 in this brand new job. There was nothing like it on the Cape at the time, and so it was very exciting. I got to build it from the ground up.
That is great. It's wonderful. What is the number? What are the numbers that you deal with? How many people do you see in the course of, say, a week?
It depends. I generally have anywhere from 15 to 20 kids in my caseload. Some of them aren't every week. Mm-hmm. And then I have parents and grandparents, as I said, who tend to see me more in the during the morning hours. I do a lot of collaboration with the schools. So I'm often down in classrooms or doing suicide prevention trainings or, you know, anything that they want help with and support with.
I see. So you have a relationship with the schools and the teachers.
Yeah, very close.
And so they would be inclined to recommend to families, perhaps, that they could avail themselves of your services.
Yes.
Or they also may let you know that they are concerned about a particular...
Yes,
child?
Usually the way the referral process works is that they contact the guidance department. The guidance department then contacts the parent and said, do you know that this resource is available for Harwich kids? And they give the parent or guardian my phone number. So,
That sounds like a very good way of making sure that everybody knows that that's available.
Yeah, it's great. That's also, they I get a lot of referrals through the court. Although the juvenile courts these days are... trying more and more not to, have kids get legally involved in the system. So very often a juvenile probation officer that I know will give a parent my name as well if they know that it's a Harwich kid.
I see. Right.
Yeah.
Okay. And where do you actually meet with them? Where is your office?
I meet at the Elbro House, which is right next to Town Hall. It's that beautiful old Queen Anne building. It's an ideal location because it's very private and confidential, and it's an easy walk from school if the kid's in high school.
Oh, yeah. Okay, good.
centrally located.
Yes.
Okay, and I know you do a lot of other things than straight counseling. What what kinds of other initiatives are there that you're involved in and that you've probably started yourself?
A lot.
Yeah, I'd love to hear about some of them.
When I first started in my job, about 85% of my job was probably counseling, and now it's about 70. Mm-hmm. And so the other 30% of the time I spend doing the suicide prevention trainings that I mentioned, going into health classes, talking to kids about areas of concern for them, planning with students usually events. We just had a event at the high school that was very well attended. That was a film called Screenagers, growing up in the digital age, and it it's something that's of a great interest to parents because they don't really know what to do with kids and the cell phones and the internet, and you know how much time should they be spending, what kind of limit should I put on it, and so it was very well attended.
Wonderful.
And the Monomoy peer leaders ran the whole night, which was great. It's a great class of kids.
The Monomoy High School.
Yeah, yeah. Uh-huh. They're all juniors and seniors. And so we'll do events like that. I also am going to be facilitating at a youth summit that is being presented by a company called Behavioral Health Innovations. And the theme is My Choice Matters. So it has to do with substance abuse and use. And the way that they've set it up is so wonderful because it's not going to be preachy and telling kids what to do. It's more them really involving themselves in critical thinking about substance abuse. So
will the peer leaders from the high school be involved in that as well?
I think there's
will
a couple
of them
that
be attending.
They sort of randomly chose kids to come. We have 33 kids coming, I think, from the high school. There's going to be 150 kids there.
So it's a regional
event. From different
event.
Schools, yes. Yeah, it'll be at the college, at the community college.
Is it all Cape Cod schools?
Yes, yes.
Oh, great.
Yeah, yeah. It's going to be really exciting. We did a run through of it, sort of a dress rehearsal, and it's got a lot of really fun interactive stuff, so it's not going to be us facilitators sitting in these groups sort of lecturing kids, and you know, that would be boring for them, so
yes, that sounds like the right way to do it, is to really get them involved, and it's part of the whole peer leader approach too,
right,
is to have them really create their own curriculum and ideas and come up with the solutions, right?
The other thing that's happening that's exciting is that I got some funds to do the Youth Risk Behavior Survey, which is a Massachusetts, I think it's a national survey. Again, for 2016, and we did one in 2014.
Ah, okay.
And we're gonna have a rollout of the data and how the two compare over
Excellent.
2 years. And
yes.
the thing that's so
That'd
great about the survey is that it gives parents, myself, and educators really clear indications of the areas we need to target.
Yes.
So
yes.
one of the areas, for instance, this year where there was an increase was texting and driving, which is a very scary thing that kids do and adults do too. Not that I stopped doing it the first time my wheel even moved. It's just a silly thing to do. There's plenty of time to text.
Yes.
And so that might be an area that we would do an event around, you know, that kind of thing. So it just gives really good data about what needs to happen.
Exactly. So you know what direction to move in.
Exactly.
Excellent. That sounds really good. I had heard about the Girl Power groups, which sound really great. Those are going to be starting in May sometime.
Again,
right?
Yes. We just finished one. We did three this year. We usually do two. It's a 6-week intergenerational program with third and fourth grade girls paired with senior women. And we do it here in the community center. So the kids come and they do some kind of physical activity, which is great because they get out of school and they're like puppies, you know, they want to run around.
Yes.
It's so cute.
Great outlet.
So we do a 45-minute physical thing and then some kind of a lesson about self-esteem, personal safety, nutrition, something like that they can do with their senior partner. And there's a healthy snack involved during the afternoon, and it's really great. And the kids
come out
of it just wanting to do it again. So.
Yes, as do the seniors, I'm sure.
Yeah, they love it. Oh, they form really lasting relationships with these senior women. Some of them get together with them after the program is over.
What is the ratio of adults to children in that?
It's 2-to-1. Yeah. Uh-huh. So there's two kids for one senior woman.
Ah.
Yeah.
Well, that's great. Mm-hmm. That's very good. Okay. Yeah. So you have the Parenting for Prevention Summit coming up.
Mm-hmm. Yep. We had one last year, and we're planning the next one, which will be in the fall. And what the first one we did identified were four risk factors mm-hmm. that might put a kid at risk when they're little for mm-hmm. possibly developing a substance abuse disorder.
Yeah.
And so there was a speaker, Dr. Ruth Pote, who's an amazing mm-hmm. speaker, mm-hmm. and she was sort of the keynote, and then we had lunch, and then mm-hmm. broke out into groups according to your child's age. Mm-hmm. So I'm not sure what the theme is for the fall. We're planning it right now. I'm working with the Barnstable County Regional Substance Abuse Commission, which is mm-hmm. an amazing group that formed in 2015 and mm-hmm. Did a huge assessment of the county, and I'm on the prevention end of things. That's why, obviously.
Right. Speaking of that, can you tell me a little more about what you do with the suicide prevention groups? Where is that? Is that for the high school?
Yeah, we do it right in school. Mm-hmm. We may be doing middle school, 7th grade also, because believe it or not, there have been kids that have suicidal thoughts and mm-hmm. attempts at that mm-hmm. age. It's heartbreaking.
Of course. Yes.
But what it is that we go class to class. Mm-hmm. And we do, we did the whole school last year, so we're only doing a couple of grades this year. Mm. And they watch a video that's teenagers in skits mm-hmm. with various situations mm-hmm. and how they respond. Like, yep. And the first one is no, and the second one is this is how you do it.
Yes.
And mm-hmm. The acting is not bad. You know, mm-hmm. some of these videos are pretty boring.
Yes.
But this one's pretty good. And then afterwards we talk about it, and if they want to, they fill out a self-screen.
Yes.
That sort of any kind of mm-hmm. thing, and if they...
So you allow that to be an optional
activity.
Yeah,
the parents have to opt in.
Oh, I see.
Very uh-huh. few say no. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And then what happens if they do have enough questions that they answer positive, they yes. go down to guidance, and we make sure that they either have a therapist or they get referred or... You know, the parent knows uh-huh. that they're having a hard time and struggling. And the thing that the program does more than anything else is that it encourages kids to bring their friends down, because
yes.
then they don't
yes.
try to play junior therapist when they don't know
right.
whether
it increases awareness
yeah.
and it allows them to know when to ask for help too,
yep.
right?
Yep.
Because they can only do so much.
Yes, and they know the difference between sadness and depression and all
right,
that stuff.
Right, exactly.
So, and SOS, it's called, Signs of Suicide
yes,
Prevention.
Yes,
really, really good program. I love it. They give us materials every year, mm-hmm, and they're wonderful mm-hmm. to work with.
Yeah,
so.
That's a great program, and I think the main thing is that kids go to kids.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And so having the kids really be the front line and understand what they need to do mm-hmm. is so important.
And to go to a trusted and
exactly.
experienced adult.
Know what they need to do and what they cannot do.
Right.
And when they should refer to someone else.
And the thing that they yes. come away with a lot of the time, too, is that suicidal feelings are often really not about actually wanting their physical person to not be around anymore. It's
yes.
more about that they're just dealing with overwhelming stress and anxiety and, mm-hmm. and sadness, and they don't know what to do with it. So
right.
If
right.
they, most people that go into counseling never even think about it again as an option. So,
mm-hmm.
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
yeah.
So. Okay. Well, it sounds like you have a lot going on, and it's a wonderful resource for the town. So do you have a website that people could check into in terms
yes.
of how to reach you?
If they go on the town website
mm-hmm.
and they have the links to departments, they can get into the website that
okay.
way.
Okay.
I also have a Harwich Youth Services Facebook page that I try to keep
mm-hmm.
current on,
mm-hmm.
and I post a lot of things to the Lower Cape Moms website
okay.
Facebook page too, which is
okay.
a great group. So, yeah, they can definitely go on the website and
okay.
find out. Yeah.
And anyone who has a concern about their own child can mm-hmm. call you
yes.
or at any point. Is
at
that
any
right?
Point, yep.
You're totally accessible for.
Yes.
For the general public in Harwich.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I am.
Well, it's a wonderful service.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming in. This is Sheila House from Youth Services that we've just been speaking with, and thank you very much.
Thanks.
You know, to have a youth counselor in town is just wonderful. It really
so
is.
So needed, and it's wonderful that we have. We have a great town here.
We really do. I mean, that service alone is wonderful. And Sheila does a great job.
Yes,
and
she does.
Dinah, thank you for that. That was really well done. Mm-hmm. And Paul, you have a very important announcement there.
That's right. Monday, April 17th.
That's right.
Patriots Day.
It's going to be Patriots Day.
That's right.
And the community center will be closed.
Yes.
And so will a lot of other town buildings. And except the trash.
That's right.
You always, yeah, that's you right. always yes. empty your trash.
You can always empty your trash, except around Christmas, down. I guess, yeah.
But all the other buildings will be closed, so don't come here to the community center.
Right.
There'll be nobody here.
The lights will be out.
Very good. Folks, that's our program for this week. Thank you so much for joining us on behalf of all of us here at Channel 18. We appreciate it.
Yes, and please take advantage of everything we've told you about.
And please do it safely.
Yeah. Very important.
Take care, folks. Bye-bye for now.
Bye-bye.